Today is Harry's first day here at home care. Right, Harry?
Right.
Okay, Harry, dear. I'm gonna pick you up later, okay? I'm going now.
Okay, bye, Mommy.
Bye-bye, son.
Bye-bye. And don't worry, we're gonna have a great time here today. Aren't we, Harry? Aren't we gonna have a great time today?
Gee, I hope so.
With blocks?
Me.
You, Daniel?
Yes.
Okay, good. And who wants to read a book?
Me.
You, Dylan? Oh,
yes.
Dylan, I've got a great book for you. Now, who would like to play with the clay?
Me.
Muhammad, you want to play with the clay?
Yeah.
Very good. How about you, Harry? What do you want to do?
Nothing. I'll just wait here for my mom to come pick me up.
Oh, but Harry, your mom won't be back to pick you up for a while.
Yeah, I know.
I think you need me to sing you a special song that I sing to people who feel the way you feel right now. Will you listen? Your mom went to work. She couldn't stay here. But you want her back.
Yeah. Mommy, come here.
You got those blues. You've got those miss your mama blues.
I miss you, Mommy.
Your mom will be back.
But when?
At the end of the day.
Yeah, but right now that seems a long time. Mommy blue.
Oh, Harry, don't worry. Now hold it right there. I know you feel blue. But we've got great stuff here to do.
What?
Got crayons and paint. We got glitter and glue. We got puzzles and books.
Yes, I do. Thanks, Lillian.
Oh, you're welcome, Harry.
You want to play with me?
Yeah! Hi, everybody.
Hi, Harry!
Wow! Hey, come here. You want to see this great plant I grew from like a tiny seed?
Yeah.
No, wait till you see this, man. It's incredible.
Oh, well, it looks funny.
Oh, well, maybe it's asleep.
Well, wake it up, man.
All right. Hey, plant, wake up.
No, I think you have to, like, get an alarm clock or something. Oh, you know what? I just remembered. My dog always wakes me up.
Oh, all right. Hey, Rex. Come on, boy. Come on in here. Hey, yeah, that's a good boy.
Hey, Rex, how's it going? Look, wake up the plant, okay?
You know, my mother says a shower always wakes her up.
Well, man, I gotta remember that. Oh, how could I be so dumb? Plants need water, man.
There's a place where I can sit, just me, myself, and I, on my pond.
On my pond.
On my pond. Where the water's fresh and clean and peaceful as a sigh. On my pond.
On my pond.
On my pond. Look at the grass all around me. It's green as the smile on my face. Look at the trees, they astound me. Wow, what a beautiful place. There's a spot where no one lives but quiet little fish. On my pond.
On my pond.
On my pond. Nature lets me come and visit anytime I wish. On my pond.
On my pond.
On my pond. Look at us all, we're enjoying a breath of sweet country air. Hey, this is getting annoying. Please keep it down. Who said you could dump your garbage here? On my pond.
On my pond.
On my pond. Cleaning it all up again could take us years and years. On my pond.
On my pond.
On my pond. Keeping it clean to begin with. Yes, that's the smart thing to do.
Don't let them cover our things with any more black slimy goo.
Save a place where I can sit, just me, myself, and I. On my pond.
On my pond.
On my pond. The water fresh and clean and peaceful as a sigh. On my pond.
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 Nicer? Is everything all cleaned up like this?
On my pond.
Ribbit, ribbit. Ribbit, ribbit, ribbit. Ribbit, ribbit, ribbit.
Ribbit, ribbit, ribbit.
Ribbit, ribbit, ribbit.
Ribbit, ribbit, ribbit.
Ribbit, ribbit, ribbit.
Gloria Globe? You look terrible. What's wrong?
Oh, I don't feel very good. I'm all out of shape, and I'm losing all my color. I'm just not as green or as blue as I used to be. It's no wonder I don't feel so well. Look at all this trash. I bet I have a temperature.
Well, don't just sit there. Help her.
You know, he's right. You can help clean me up if you just remember not to litter and put all your trash into cans. Then I'd feel on top of the world in no time.
Wow, look at all these cars. They're going really fast.
Now they're going really slow.
Now they're going fast.
Now they're going slow again.
Fast.
Slow.
Fast.
Slow.
Now they're going fast again.
They must be in heaven.
Good evening, everyone. Good evening. And welcome to the first annual reunion of all the things that start with that special sound, shh. Thank you. Thank you. Wonderful. And now, if everyone's finished with their shish kebab and sherbet, I'd like to introduce our first after-dinner speaker, someone who has some very special feelings about the sound, shh. Please welcome A Shirt. Yes, wonderful. Come on in. Come on in.
Thank you, Guy. You know, I may be hand-stitched from the world's finest silk, mm-hmm. but if it weren't for shh, I'd be nothing but ert.
Right.
Thank you.
Wonderful. Thank Great. You. Okay, thank you. And now, please welcome a shoe. Ah. Come on up, come on.
Excuse me.
Yep, step right up there, shoe.
Excuse me.
Okay.
Excuse me.
It's okay. Don't be nervous.
Hmm? Oh, I'm not nervous.
But you're shaking.
Well, that's because shake starts with shh, just like shoe.
Oh, wonderful. A shaking shoe. Isn't that terrific? Okay. And now our next speaker is a shovel. Oh. Yeah. Wait a second. Shh. Tell me, Shovel, is something wrong?
I'm shy.
Aww. Don't be shy.
Okay.
It's a shrieking shovel. Let's make her feel right at home. Okay, that's fine.
Excuse me. I'd like to say something.
Well, who are you?
I'm a king.
But king doesn't start with shh.
No, but short does, and I'm a very short king.
But surely...
And don't call me Shirley.
Oh!
Excuse me. Hmm? Is this the special dinner for all the things that start with shh?
That's right. Who are you?
A shepherd.
Well, shepherd starts with shh. Yeah. Why don't you join us?
I can't. I'm trying to find my sheep. Oh, they ran away. Have you seen them?
Well, sheep starts with shh.
Yes.
Yeah. Any sheep here?
No.
No.
Oh, there they are. You stay right there.
Hold it down in here. The neighbors are complaining.
Well, who are you?
I am the sheriff.
Well, sheriff starts with shh. How about some shish kebab?
Don't mind if I do.
Well, great. Wait, there's a shark.
Shark.
Look at heavens.
Shark.
Listen, we've got shortcake, and we have shrimp over here. There's a shrimp right here. And we certainly have a lot of shenanigans around here, too, don't you think?
So, what do you want to play?
How about table tapping?
Okay. How do you play that?
Well, you tap something on the table, and I'll tap the same thing back to you.
Oh, okay. But wait a minute. You're blind. That means Daniel can't see. So, how are you going to see what I'm tapping on the table?
I won't see it, but I can hear it.
All right. You'll hear it. So I'll tap something on the table, and you tap it back, and you play too. Okay, are we ready? Here we go. Yeah, how about this? Okay, here's another one. Okay, here's a big one now. All right.
Lunch is ready.
Okay. Hey, wait a minute. How do you know lunch is ready? You can't see it.
I know, but I can smell it. Spaghetti and meatballs. And some garlic, and I think there's a little bit of basil in there, too.
Wow!
Yum, 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 yum! Okay, guys, it's lunch! Spaghetti and meatballs, come and get it!
Hey, come on, Daniel, let's go!
Seven animals in a tree. Seven.
Watch my...
It's a good movie, isn't it, Bert?
Huh? Huh?
It's a good movie.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Excuse me, please. Excuse me. Oh, I'm sorry. Excuse me.
Hey, Bert.
Yeah?
A lady just came and sat down in front of me with a big tall hat. Now I can't see the movie. What'll I do?
I don't know. I figure it out yourself, Bernie. I'm trying to watch the movie. Shh.
Let's see. What shall I do? I know what. Bert?
Huh?
Bert?
What?
Hey, Bert.
What are you? What are you doing?
I'm going to change seats with you, Bert.
No, you're not, Ernie.
Oh, you
come
can
on.
See. And,
I'm watching the movie.
Shh.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Shh.
Come on, Ernie.
Okay. Let's see. Guess I'll have to think of something else. Let's see. Bert can see. Because he's sitting in a seat where he can see. I know what. I'll sit on Bert's lap.
Bert, what are you doing, Ernie? Ernie,
I'm sitting on your lap, Bert.
Ernie, get off my lap. Come on. I'm sorry. Come on. I'll sit down and be quiet.
But, Bert, how am I going to see the movie, Bert?
I
can't think of anything, Bert.
Look, Ernie, what is the trouble?
I can't see the movie, Bert. What'll I do?
Just ask the lady nicely. Please, lady, will you please take off your hat so I can see? Now leave me alone so I can watch the movie.
Okay, Bert. excuse me, miss.
Mm-hmm.
Lady,
mm-hmm.
Would you mind taking off your hat so I can see the movie?
Oh, not at all. I'm sorry.
That's very nice of you. Oh.
Is that better?
That's fine. Thank you very much. Thank you too, Bert.
Any eyeball, PhD, looks at air. She cannot see it. Dr. Eyeball tries listening to it with her ears, feeling it with her fingers, smelling it with her nose, tasting it with her tongue. Nothing. Yet, Dr. Annie Eyeball, like scientists the world over, is convinced that air is everywhere around us. Never discouraged, Dr. Eyeball returns to her laboratory to continue her untiring work exploring the secrets of air.
Excuse me, I'm looking for...
Oh, you found it! You're the Bell Sheep School of Acting! Yeah, and you are in luck because today only we're offering a free introductory lesson.
A free acting lesson?
Yeah, it's your chance to learn the Meryl Sheep method.
Oh, what is the Meryl Sheep method?
The alphabet.
The alphabet?
Yeah. Oh, it's a wonderful way to get out your feelings.
Really?
Yeah, here's what we do.
Huh.
I will show you how to act out the feeling,
mm-hmm.
and you will try to do it while you say the alphabet. Okay, are you ready?
Well, sure, why not? I guess I'm as ready as I'll ever be, okay?
Okay, now take a deep breath. Yeah, now relax, yeah. Okay, now concentrate.
Okay.
Okay.
mm-hmm.
Happy!
A.
Yeah.
B.
Good.
C.
Yeah.
D.
More.
E.
Good.
Stop.
Sad.
Yeah. H.
Yeah.
I.
I believe it.
J.
Good. Angry.
Angry.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay. L.
Yeah.
M.
More.
N.
Good.
O.
Stop. Afraid.
Afraid.
Yeah.
P.
Good.
Q. R. S.
Yes.
lovingly, oh, lovingly, lovingly.
Think?
You, V.
Good.
W.
Yeah.
X. Y.
No. Proud.
Z.
Oh!
Z.
Oh! Thanks. That was wonderful. Yeah, I've never heard a more touching alphabet.
Oh, yeah, I really felt that sad part. Thanks very much.
Now, what did you say your name was?
Susan Sarandon.
Susan Sarandon. Yeah. Now, could you just put your name on this piece of paper?
Oh, thanks very much, but I don't want any more acting lessons.
No, no. I'm not going to ask you to sign up for lessons, dear. This is your diploma. Yeah, congratulations.
Oh,
you have learned the Merrill Sheep method in just one lesson.
Thanks to you.
Yeah. Let me know when you get your first acting job, okay?
Well,
and don't get discouraged, Sue, if it takes a while. Yeah. I have a feeling you're going to be big. Yeah. You may even become a star.
Five children take away two children, leave one, two, three children. Three children take away three children, leave zero children. Oh, no children at all. How sad.
I've never seen this place look so fancy. It's nice. Candle on the table, fresh tablecloth. But still the same old service. I've been here 15 minutes and still no waiter. Waiter! Waiter!
Good evening, sir. Oh, hello there. Nice to see you again, sir. I am your waiter.
Grover.
Yes. I knew you knew that. I would like to point out the changes in this restaurant. Beside the decor, notice the bell.
Oh, what's that for?
That bell, sir, is for you. Each customer has a bell on their own table. From now on, you do not have to scream, waiter, waiter! No, in a highfalutin dinery like this here, you merely ring the bell. You see? Ring it like that. If sir does that, I shall come to wait on your personage. Excuse me, sir. Three bells. That is my signal. I am being beckoned elsewhere.
But... listen, I only have a little...
I only have two ears.
Look. Well, he said he'd come if I rang a bell like that. I might have known it wouldn't work. Waiter! Waiter!
Sir, why are you screaming, waiter, in a classy, greasy spoon like this?
You said if I wanted you, ring the bell three times.
Right.
Well, I rang the bell three times just like you told me. And you didn't come, so I screamed.
Well, but I'm not supposed to come right away when you... No, if you want me right away, you are supposed to ring the bell like this. You see? And then I will come a-running.
You didn't tell me that.
Well, I did not tell all the other customers either, but they seem to get it. It is common sense. Now listen, if you ring fast like this, I shall come fast. If you ring slow like this, I shall come to you slowly. Now, do you think you can understand that?
All right. I've had enough. I want to speak to the manager.
Oh, I do not think you want to see the manager.
Don't tell me what I want. I know what I want. I want to see the manager him that these bells are no good.
Fine. Very well. To call the manager, you hit the bell four times.
Four times. Ring the bell four times. Thank you
very much. You're welcome. Oh, here comes Andy.
What for you ring bell? Interrupt Andre while eating sour cream souffle.
Well, actually, I can't explain that. You see, he said...
Andre, I believe Andy, he just wanted to tell you...
His
opinion, the bells, which I recall were your idea, were they not? The bells, he thinks, are no good.
Bell not good? Bell look good? Bell look very good. Delicious. Now what's wrong with Bell?
Oh, my. Look at the time.
Probably going to tell his friends about the place. Oh, excuse me. Coming!
Okay, lay any word beginning with R on me, and I'll show you some magic stuff.
Okay, rabbit.
Rabbit. Keep it coming.
Rocking. Rock.
Not bad, huh?
Radio. Rope.
Anything beginning with R.
Rat.
Keep it coming.
Rip. Rain.
Better get under this umbrella, kid.
Okay, I'm ready. Rain!
You're wet!
Mr. Hatfoot!
You need something, Elmo?
Yeah. Will you come out here and light the candle on this birthday cake?
Sure.
Good!
Well, now, who's the cake for?
The fan.
The fan?
Yeah.
Elmo.
What?
A fan is just a machine that blows air. It can't have a birthday.
Oh, Mr. Hatfoot, Elmo knows that. But Elmo can make believe the fan is having a birthday party. Yeah. Oh, Mr. Hatfoot, can you light the birthday cake, please? Oh, very good. Now Elmo will sing to Elmo's fan. Like this. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear fan. Happy birthday to you.
Okay. Okay. All right. Now, what was that for? Why?
Oh, because Elmo was to watch the fan blow out the candles on its cake. Like this. Oh, yay! Happy birthday, fan!
To get to the other side. Oh, I get it. To get to the other side. That's a good one.
Oh, Bert. Hey, Bert. I brought home a surprise, Bert.
That's nice, Ernie.
And Bert, you're going to guess what it is.
Oh, Ernie. Just tell me, okay?
But, Bert, if I told you what it is, it wouldn't be a surprise, would it? Besides that, this is going to be a lot of fun. You ready, Bert?
Huh?
I say, are you ready, Bert?
Okay, Ernie.
Okay, I'll give you a clue, okay? Your first clue is that it's little, Bert.
Little?
Mm-hmm.
Ernie, what kind of clue is that? That could be anything.
Well, it couldn't be Big Bird.
No, it couldn't be.
But I'll give you another clue. It's little and it's cute, Bert.
Ernie.
And it has four legs.
Wait, little, cute, and has four legs. I know, two pigeons.
Bert, you're not trying.
Well.
No, listen. This cute little four-legged creature has a waggly tail and a cold nose.
A waggly tail and a cold nose.
And it rhymes with guppy.
With gup.
And it sounds like that.
It's a puppy! Oh, Ernie!
You're right, Bert.
Oh, look at him.
Isn't he cute?
Oh, he's so terrific.
Yeah, what do you think we should name him, Bert?
Norman.
Norman?
Yeah.
How about something like Godzilla the Wonder Dog?
How about Norman?
How about we name him Bert?
How about Alan?
Alan?
Yeah, how about Jim?
Are you a wasted fruit? Freedom Bailey, wasted water. Just pretty little white. She left the water dripping, dripping, dripping while she ran off to play. She's a pearer, a molly poo. She's wasted water. She's a waste of room. Are you a waste of room? Sherman Cox washed his hands. He left the water running, running, running. Wasted water down the drain. That water can't be used again. He's a fritterer, a molly poo. He wasted water. He's a waste of room. Are you a waste of room? Now Sherman Cox and Frieda Bailey.
In the wintertime, the woods are very quiet. And the animals, they hibernate. Bears, skunks, chipmunks, they go to sleep all through the cold winter months. There's no leaves on the trees in wintertime. Lots of birds go down south at winter time where it's warm. I like to look for deer tracks. It's very hard for deer to find food in the winter time. The deer come and eat apples off our apple tree. It's rainy in the springtime. All the snow melts. The water runs into the ground. The streams fill full of water, and the trees drink their water through the roots. Then all the leaves grow back on. Geese and the ducks, all the birds come back. And all the animals wake up. The leaves, the grass, everything turns to green. The flowers all grow. Red, purple, pink. I love the smell of flowers. And best of all, I like to run through the fields.
Gentlemen and sardines, Miss Ethel Mermaid!
I get no kick out of it. The C and D are just letters to me. And E makes me endlessly blow. But I get a kick out of you. No fun from an F. G, E, H, and I nearly cars me aside. And J really makes me go ho. But I get a kick out of you. A, L, M, N, O, B, Q, R, S. Astonishing one, you see.
Don't appeal to her. She's nuts for what's between them.
On his first day at home care.
He did very well. A little shaky at first, but after that he did great.
Oh, good.
Harry, your mom's here.
Mommy. Oh, hi, Mommy.
Hi, son. Lillian says you did real good today.
Oh, it was swell, Ma. And I made something great.
Oh, yeah? You mean you helped make one of those corn husk dolls over there?
Well, yeah, but I also made something else.
Huh. Oh, you helped make that piñata up there?
Yeah, but something else, too.
Huh. Oh, you helped make the pictures over there?
Well, yeah, but I also made something besides all that.
What?
I made a new friend. This is Daniel, Mommy. We've been playing together all day, right, Daniel?
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, Daniel, let's go play with those blocks some more.
Okay.
Hey, wait, Harry! We have to go home! Oh, dear.
Doorways up and down the halls. Wonder what's behind them all. Doors that lead to anywhere. Got to ABC, what's there? Got to ABC, decide. Where's the door? I haven't tried. ABC, D, east to west. Growing on an apple quest.
I'm on a rambling road, rambling by some rocks and a radio, and a rabbit, hi rabbit, and a rock and roll record. A red ribbon? No, a rainbow. Remarkable.
Seven rabbits.
We take you now to Kermit the Frog with another fast-breaking news story.
I don't know why they call it the tortoise and the hare. I mean, why don't they just call it the turtle and the rabbit? Hmm? Oh, hi-oh, Kermit the Frog here to report on what is being billed as the race of the century, a rematch between the tortoise and the hare. Now, as you track fans will recall, the first time these two met, the hare was a heavy favorite. But the tortoise, using a strategy which he called slow but steady, won the race. And now these two competitors will meet again. In just a moment, wait a second, hold on. I think the hare is coming to the track.
You know.
Let's see if we can get in a word with him.
Who asked you? What do you know?
Excuse me, hare. Kermit the Frog of Sesame Street News. Could you give us a prediction of the outcome of today's race?
Yeah, I'm gonna win.
Mm-hmm. And why is that?
What do you think? Because I'm fast.
Wow.
Fast, see?
Mm. Yes, indeed. And yet last time you lost the race.
I took a nap, okay? Mm. This time I'm gonna win. You know why? Because I'm fast.
Mm, yes, I think you mentioned that already. Wait a second. Listen to that roar. I think here comes the tortoise. The tortoise, ladies and gentlemen. There he is.
Look at this guy. Mm. Pathetic. Pathetic. I'm fast, he's slow. I'm fast, he's slow. Fast, slow. Fast, slow. Nyeh, 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 nyeh.
Excuse me?
Uh-huh.
Oh, he's giving up before he even starts.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it does seem to be true. The tortoise does seem to have left the track.
Runners to the starting line.
Excuse me.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the race is about to begin, and there is no sign of the tortoise.
He's not even gonna try.
On your marks.
That's no tortoise. He's a chicken.
Get set.
Excuse me.
That, folks, was fast.
Oh, the winner!
The tortoise! The tortoise is a winner once again, ladies and gentlemen!
He wasn't a... He didn't even...
Yes, he was, and he did.
Hey, somebody look up under the rule book. Look under C for cheating. He didn't... I wasn't... They were... They... I wasn't there.
To get ready for school. I wash myself and brush my teeth. My mother gives me my lunch for school. I walk past my neighbors. We all play when we get to school. And then the bell rings for class to begin. Sasha passes out chalk.
Write them on the slate. A boy, a girl, a man, a woman. Is it a man?
No, it is a boy.
Eh?
No, it is a boy.
We are learning to read and write. We jump in class.
We jump, we jump, and we jump. We jump, we jump, and we jump.
And we really jump when school is out.
So, who's the present for, Elmo?
The fan. It's a birthday present.
The fan? Hey, didn't we just say that the fan is just a machine?
Yeah.
Well, it's not alive. It doesn't eat. It doesn't breathe. It doesn't grow.
Oh, yeah. Elmo already knows that the fan is not alive.
Well, then why are you giving the fan a birthday present?
Because Elmo wants to see the fan open the present.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
And how's it going to do that?
Elmo will show you. Boy. Elmo, hope you like your present, man.
Well, that was pretty good,
yeah.
Elmo. What's in the box?
Nothing.
Nothing? What do you mean, nothing?
It's a fan. A fan. Mr. Hanford, what you gonna get for a fan?
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters R. And U.
U.
And by the number 7.
7.
Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
Happy birthday, Phil!
Funding for this program is provided in part by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and by public television stations and their contributors.